Throughout the 1950s and 60s, Playboy enterprises challenged orthodox values pertaining to sexuality. This was very apparent in women as a whole because it allowed them to stray away from previous conservative perceptions such as being modest. Playboy provided new forms of entertainment that catered to couples and singles alike.
So what was and is Playboy? It is a company that promotes the concept of sex as a recreation. Its magazines publish nude photographs of women along with its controversial and stimulating articles. It also ran a chain of clubs starting in 1960 that used women dressed as bunnies to entertain and serve the guests.
Firing line with William F. Buckley Jr. and Hugh Hefner. Tonight, the Playboy philosophy.
Hugh Hefner was born in 1926 in Chicago to a conservative Protestant family. His family did embrace the different kinds of modernity that were changing in society at the time, which probably led him to conceive the first issue of Playboy magazine, published in 1953. The magazine sold out so quickly that 7 years later, the first Playboy Club opened up in Chicago.
We began to promote an attitude in terms of single life that obviously became, in the 1960s, the sexual revolution.
The sexual revolution was a social movement that went against traditional codes of behavior related to sexuality. It was throughout the U.S. during the time period of 1960 to 1980. This sexual revolution allowed the rise of a permissive society. Along with mainstream media, the advances in science and medicine also affected this revolution.
Well, in terms of achievements, I think it is my part in the changing social-sexual values of our time. I think I take particularly pride in that.
There is no doubt that Playboy influenced the changing times during the 1960s, but how did it do it, and why was it such a big deal? Through Playboy's popularity, the ideas contained in it not only reached the stereotypical single men who were presumed to read Playboy, but all genders and ages. It reached them through media and especially through the controversy that went on because of it. Even recent media focuses on the long-gone Playboy clubs.
You know, no one thinks this is funny.
How funny is this?
So what part of Playboy influenced people's minds? This content that was included in Playboy magazine and the principles put into the clubs really changed people's thoughts about sexual values. Looking through articles and editorials within and about Playboy enterprises shows an important shift of consciousness towards a freer and more accepted expression of sexuality that was occurring. Overall, Playboy was a huge aspect in the sexual revolution through its influencing content.
Flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky.
Putting the bunny costume on the first time was just, I couldn't wait.
Playboy gave women the freedom to be both sexual and morally withheld. They were able to break away from the long-lived stereotypes as taking on the roles of housewives and mothers, there to serve the family. This change began in the early ages of Playboy. Playboy needed the women for its customers, and many women needed Playboy to provide for their families.
Some nights you'd make $100, $200 in one night. We were making more money than most men were making at that time.
Although some women felt objectified, many women felt that they were released from the social clutches of female perception.
Good. Walk through that room. Own it.
Take away from a woman her own ability to be sexually appealing. You dehumanize her.
You were definitely feminist. I mean, you had to be.
As the publication sales of Playboy skyrocketed through the roof, Hugh Hefner realized he could take the Playboy philosophy to an entirely different dimension. In February 1960, Hefner opened the first Playboy Club in the booming city of Chicago. The club itself was structured around the very values that the magazines had. An intellectually stimulating environment, the finest musical guests, personalities, and live entertainment. And of course, lots and lots of skin. Playboy was also influential because of its unique billing system that had never been seen before.
In those days, we weren't electronically or technical as we are now.
Right.
But there was, each member had a key, and the back of the key had a number.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I had a friend that came in, and that he was my former boss, and he would come in, and I'd read the key, and then I'd write down the order. And then we had to go, before we placed the order with the bartender, we had to go to this little machine. It was like an addressograph, or some kind of addressograph machine. And we had to write on it, Mr. So-and-so, and a key number on this pad. It was like an etch-a-sketch, if you want enough to compare it to something. And then there's these couple men, like security guys, they were working down in the key room. And we would proceed to write this guy's name. And then we'd go over to the bartender, and we'd start setting up the glasses on our tray. You know, and if a girl was in front of me, we'd try to work around each other. And so I'd be setting up my glasses on the tray and putting ice in them and, you know, figuring out my call-in order. And then if we saw this, there was a phone by this machine, and if it started flashing red, we had to pick it up, and the guy in the key room would say, "You can't serve this customer, he hasn't paid his bill."
Oh, wow.
So in present day, you know, we would take the guy's credit card, and the guy's credit card is bad, we would just say, "Sir, we didn't have that technology then."
Yeah, that's
because
nice.
Everything was done, it was like a private billing system.
The success of the clubs were unimaginably large, and it became more evident that the only way to make Playboy even more successful was to expand the clubs into different cities around the U.S. The Playboy Club was a way to become a part of the so-revered magazine, someone who was classy, mysterious, and of course, interesting. And the only leading example of someone that exemplified what a Playboy truly was Hugh Hefner himself.
You have the time of your life. Just make sure that you bring your wife. You can keep Las Vegas. Give me the Playboy in Chicago. And this is my
overall, Playboy's influence liberated women during the sexual revolution.
The last Playboy Club closed in 1988. Interviews and articles show that the sexual revolution had taken its course. Many new magazines that were similar to Playboy were being published. Photos in these magazines were even more provocative than the first rendition of Playboy. These clubs had died, but the magazine still continues on today. Also, in the late 1970s, Playboy clubs went public. People had become less interested in them because they were not exclusive as they had been. Although many thought that the content Playboy promoted was dehumanizing, many women benefited from Playboy's job offerings. They were able to use its money and feel great about themselves while on the job. Without Playboy Enterprises, much of the sexual revolution would be missing. Entertainment, sexual perception, and women have been changed forever since the times of Playboy.